How are they using the principles of Agile or Scrum transporting that sugar from here to here? I found that unique, very innovative, very fun way of actually depicting some of these things.
When you give a right answer to a question that has been passed by the other team, then you get 5 marks for that. You still get 15 seconds for answer, that time as well. Obviously, when you pass something, you don't get any marks, but you get plus 0. For a long answer, you get minus 5. So, obviously, there's a penalty there. Now, every team gets one bumper question in each round. And you will have to tell before we start the round which question you want to be the bumper. Okay, so you don't know what's going to come. And you have a choice to choose your question 1 or question 2 or question 3 or question 4 will be bumper round. And the bumper round, for the right answer, you will get 50 marks. And for the wrong answer, you will get, you will lose 25 marks. But everybody will have one shot at the bumper round, the bumper question in each round. Right? The only thing is, it's up to you, but you will have to tell it upfront. You cannot make up your mind depending on how the questions are going and then try to guess. Maybe next one might be simple, I'll do that. So I need from you which question is going to be bumper round for you so that we can keep a track of it here itself from a marking perspective. Right? Before we start there. So you can, if you say second question, or you say third question, or you say fourth question, you say first question, then we'll have to keep a track of it. It's complex, but we'll do that. But it's clear, right?
The last round will not have a bumper round. Fun and final.
Fun and final itself is a big bumper, actually. Right? We'll come to that in a moment.
Do you have to take a bumper
question? It's up to you if you don't want to take it. You can skip it if you don't want to take it. But it's a great opportunity for people who are running low on the score to play a gamble, basically. Right? We were thinking, Ritesh, why don't we do a phone and friend? We said, maybe timing, we'll have logistic issues with Vijay, but we wanted to do a phone and friend kind of a thing there. So anyway, bumper question is clear to all of you. In both the rounds, you have an opportunity. Before we start round one, you'll have to tell which question you want to make bumper. If you don't want to take bumper, that's okay. You don't need to do that.
What if you don't answer the bumper question?
You don't get anything.
It's not like negative answer.
It's not negative answer. It's only in the wrong answer that you will be negative. And final round, everybody, the team that comes second will get 60, 40, and 20. Now, what they will do as an activity, we'll come to that when we further extend the team for that. You have some sheets here, so you will actually do some activity there and then demonstrate something at the end of that. Right?
Is
the
bumper question
can be
asked on the same
way? No. Bumper is only for you. If it passed, it becomes a normal question. Okay, so these rules are clear. All of you are clear. For the sake of playing this game, we'll have a golden rule that my decision will be final, even if that's a wrong answer. That's okay? Because there's always a contentious thing, right? I don't want to just say it's possible I'm wrong, but for the sake of this quiz, we'll go with only one single decision here. Right? So what I want actually people to do is keep calm and enjoy the quiz. And audience, my wholehearted request would be to prompt your team. Because the room is actually very quiet right now. So just to make it a little more fun, let me give you a bonus question. Right? How the questions are going to look like. The first team that answers it gets 10 points extra. Okay? You'll have to raise your hand and tell what you can answer. Okay, what's the right answer? Are you sure you have the right answer?
Yes.
Anyway, that was the fun part of it. I'm not going to give questions like that, right? So if you see option C, that is when C becomes the answer. I'm not going to play that kind of question yet. Okay. Smells are signs that something might be wrong. What is this smell known as? The wild fluctuations shown on a team's initial sprint burnout charts continue to be seen in much later sprints. It's B, sorry, wrong answer. Minus 5. Wants to talk, etc. What is this smell known as? You said D?
Yeah.
Sorry, wrong answer. Minus 5. You are seeing the following behavior in the team. One person dominates all the conversations and other team members won't speak until he has spoken. What is this smell known as? Okay, so the options start for you guys. Team B. You are frequently seeing this behavior. Lack of test coverage, duplicate code, more bugs start to appear, velocity slows down, etc. What appears to be the smell here?
B, technical debt.
That's right. Okay, so you go left, so that we'll make a note of it and then your points will get bodily done. You can skip it if you don't want to do that. Three, we'll take the three, we'll make a note for it, and then we'll take this as the number. Eight. Yeah. Third, okay. You're going with the, it's not like the joke is there, right? Microsoft versions get really perfect in the third iteration. Okay, let's go to the question 5 now. I mean, they didn't pass. They have to pass. If they give a wrong answer, that is not pass. So that's how it
is. If they pass, there is no penalty.
Then there is no penalty. And then it comes to the next one. Okay, question 5 is the team A. What is this diagram known as? I hope it's visible to you.
Option B.
Sorry, that's the wrong one. It's very close to that, purposefully it's been done, but the original curve by Everett Rogers is known as diffusion of innovation. So the team D. Which process is depicted here?
Option B, rapid prototyping.
Sponsors, developers, and users should be able to maintain a constant pace indefinitely. For help.
go on.
Sorry?
B, option B, go on.
You said B?
Yeah, B, go on.
Okay. It's a pass. It was fine. Bumper was there.
We actually got the bumper only.
Well, let's see, your bumper is coming up now, right? Okay. No, this is 10th is done. 11th is for you guys, right? Okay. What is this manifesto known as? On occasions, we do nothing, or something different, or something else. Because this means our teams are more effective. It also means that we are freaking awesome.
Option D, please.
D?
D for donkey.
So we all think agile is really more speed, but it's all about change actually at the end of the day that we're talking about. And lean is also about value. All the waste is pretty close there. Okay, we are done with 12. Now we'll get back to team A. What is the core values of scale agility framework? Services. Which of the following innovation names could help you most? Your options are
C, speedboat.
Okay, team C now. In SAFe, this role is known as Chief Scrum Master, who facilitates program level processes and program execution, escalates impediments, manages risk, and helps drive program level continuous improvement. What is it called?
B. Release train engineer.
Release train engineer? That's right. No, this was their own question.
No, what was the last one? Okay, yeah.
Mitesh is doing something which I don't know, so I hope you guys are
not.
Okay, team D, this is your bumper question. And the last question. What is the most common reason startups fail?
Option B.
B as in?
Boy.
Boy?
Yes.
You get plus 50 for a bumper. So this is from Project Genome. Which
thanks to the bumper, 45 marks. Team B with 0 and team A minus and negative.
Okay. So you have one more bumper round which you will have to tell before we start the round. Take a deep breath. Okay. So let's go to the first one here. And you can shout out the answer even before the question is read. It's purely your call. Right? Everybody saying C, then
A.
Okay, let's see. denominations in the planning focus set?
B.
Name,
please.